Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 15 in Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. We are going to solve problem. In the earlier lecture also, we solved a problem in the fan of flow. We continue with the problem solving. We solve additional 5 problems in the fan of flow. And you refer to the theoretical part, property variation in the fan of flow, variation of Mach number with the duct length in the prescribed booklet or video lecture, and we will solve problem here in the fan of flow. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the fan of flow. Example number 6, air flows through a circular pipe at a rate of 8.3 kilograms per second. The Mach number at inlet to the pipe is 0.15 and the exit is 0.5. The pressure and temperature at the inlet are 350 kPa and 38 degrees Celsius respectively. Assume the flow is to be adiabatic and the mean friction factor to be 0.005. Find the length and diameter of the duct. The pressure and temperature at the exit of the duct. So the given data, mass flow rate m equal to 8.3 kilograms per second, m1 equal to 0.15, Mach number m2 equal to 0.5. Pressure P1 equal to 350 kPa, temperature T1 equal to 38 degrees Celsius, and friction factor F equal to 0.005. The properties of air, gamma equal to 1.4 and R equal to 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin. The density of the air at inlet condition, rho equal to P by RT, 350 kPa, 350 into 1000 divided by 287 into 311 equal to 3.92 kilograms per metric cube. Then velocity of the air at inlet condition, C1 equal to M1 into square root of gamma RT1, which is 0.15 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 311 equal to 53 meters per second. The diameter of the duct, D equal to 4 into M dot is the mass flow rate, M dot equal to rho A into C, so 4 into M dot divided by pi into rho 1 into C1. To the power 1 by 2. Substituting 4 into 8.3 divided by 3.14 into 3.92 into 53 to the power 1 by 2 equal to 0.225 meter. The diameter of the duct equal to 0.225 meter. From the fan of flow table number 3.2, page number 81, we take m1 equal to 0.15 and gamma equal to 1.4. We take the properties P by P star, T by T star, 4 FL max by D. So, for M1 equal to 0.15, the values are 7.3195, 1.1945, 28.354. So, 0.15 may not be available directly. 0.14 and 0.16 will be available. We have to take the average of the value. And similarly, for Mach number M2 in the same page, Mach number M2 equal to 0.5, P by P star equal to 2.138, T by T star equal to 1.143, 4 FL max by D equal to 1.069. Now, the properties of the air at exit. We calculate the pressure P2, P2 equal to P1 into P2 by P star divided by P1 by P star. So, 350 into 2 into 2.138 divided by 7.3195 equal to 102.2 kPa. And T2, temperature T2 equal to T1 into T2 by T star divided by T1 by T star equal to 311 into 1.143 divided by 1.1945 equal to 297.6 Kelvin. And we have the equation 4 FL by D equal to 4 FL max 1 divided by D minus 4 FL max 2 divided by D. So, substituting 4 into 0.005 into L is the unknown, length is unknown, divided by 0.225 equal to 28.354 minus 1.069 equal to 27.285. So, length equal to 27.285 into 0.225 divided by 4 into 0.005 equal to 306.96 meter. So, the answer to the problem, length of the duct equal to 306.96 meter, diameter of the duct equal to 0.225 meter, pressure at exit equal to 102.2 kPa, temperature at exit equal to 297.6 Kelvin. Example number 7, air flows down a 20 millimeter diameter pipe which has a length of 0.8 meter. If the velocity at the inlet to the pipe is 200 meters per second and its temperature is 30 degrees Celsius, find the average friction factor if the flow is choked at the exit of the pipe. Assume the flow is to be adiabatic. We write down the given data, diameter equal to 0.02 meter, length equal to 0.8 meter, C1 equal to 200 meters per second, and T1 equal to 30 degree Celsius. Velocity 200 meters per second and temperature at inlet equal to 30 degree Celsius. We calculate the Mach number at inlet to the pipe. M equal to C divided by square root of gamma RT, which is 200 divided by 1.4 into 287 into 303 equal to 0.57. Then the for the fan outflow, from the fan outflow table, M equal to 0.57 and gamma equal to 1.4. So this is again gamma equal to 1.4, table number 6.2. We take 4 FL max by D equal to 0.6245. So for this value, we take 0.6245. The mean friction factor from this value, the mean friction factor F equal to 0.6245 into 0.02 divided by 4 into 0.8 equal to 0.0039. The answer to the problem, the mean friction factor F equal to 0.0039. Example number 8, air enters an insulated pipe with a diameter of 7.5 cm and a Mach number of 3. As a result of friction, the Mach number decreases to a value of 1.5 at the exit to the pipe. If the mean friction factor is equal to 0.002, find the length of the pipe. So it is at the entry, it is supersonic flow. Throughout the pipe, it is supersonic flow. Mach number inlet Mach number is 3, exit Mach number is 1.5. So, diameter equal to 7.5 cm, M1 equal to 3, M2 equal to 1.5, friction factor equal to 0.002. From the fan outflow table, 6.2, page number 85 and 83. So, Mach number 1 properties are available at page number 85 and Mach number 1.5 is available in page number 83. Gamma equal to 1.4 for both the cases. 4 FL max by D. For M1 equal to 3, it is 0.522. For M2 equal to 1.5, it is 0.136. For fan outflow, we know 4 FL divided by D equal to 4 FL max 1 divided by D minus 4 FL max 2 divided by D. Now, substituting the values, 4 into 0.002 into L divided by 0.075 equal to 0.522 minus 0.136 equal to 0.386. So, from this equation, length of the duct L equal to 0.386 into 0.075 divided by 4 into 0.002 equal to 3.62 meter. So, the answer to the problem, length of the duct equal to 3.62 meters. Example number 9, air flows down a constant area pipe which has a diameter of 5 cm. The Mach number at inlet to the pipe is 2 and the intake pressure and temperatures are 80 kPa and 20 degree Celsius respectively. The flow in the pipe can be assumed to be adiabatic. If the pipe is 0.6 meter long and the average friction factor is 0.005, find the Mach number, pressure and temperature at the exit of the pipe. On leaving the pipe, the air flows through a convergent divergent nozzle which has area ratio, exit area 3 times the throat area. And the air stream leaves the nozzle at a subsonic velocity. Find the pressure and Mach number at the exit of the nozzle if the flow is in the nozzle can be assumed as isentropic. And this is the passage. Initially, from 1 to 2, it is fan outflow. We are given D, diameter equal to 0.05 meter, Mach number M1 equal to 2, P1 equal to 80 kPa, T1 equal to 20 degree Celsius, and length equal to 0.6 meter. So, length of the pipe equal to 0.6 meter and friction factor is 0.005. Then the air leaves the fan outflow, leaves the duct, constant area duct at the property 2. We have to calculate the property 2 here. And after that, it is flowing through a convergent divergent nozzle where the area A4, exit area is 3 times the throat area, A4 by A3 equal to 3. That is what the given condition. Now, we have to first, for the fan outflow, we have to refer to the fan outflow table and calculate the properties at a exit point at the state 2. Then we have to consider isentropic flow between the state 2 and the state 4, that is in the nozzle, converging diverging nozzle. Then we have to calculate again the property at the outlet. And the condition here, in the nozzle, air leaves the nozzle at subsonic velocity. That is very important. So, here it is subsonic velocity. We solve the problem. The fan outflow table, table number 6.2, page number 84, Mach number 2, Mach number M1 equal to 2, gamma equal to 1.4. We take the property P1 by P star equal to 0.408. T1 by T star equal to 0.667, 4 FL max by D equal to 0.305. Now for the fan outflow, 4 FL max, 4 FL divided by D equal to 4 FL max divided by D1 minus 4 FL max 2 divided by D. So substituting 4 into 0.005 into 0.6 divided by 0.05, equal to 0.305 minus 4FL max 2 divided by D. Now 4FL max 2 divided by D equal to 0.305 minus 0.24 equal to 0.065. Now from the Fanon flow table, page number 83, table number 6.2, page number 83, for at gamma equal to 1.4 and the 4FL max by D equal to 0.065, we take M2 equal to 1.3, P2 by P star equal to 0.728, T2 by T star equal to 0.897. So this is the reference value. M2 is taken as 1.3. So this is directly available in the gas tables. You can directly take the properties. Now this is the exit Mach number. From the property ratio P2 by P star and T2 by T star, we calculate the pressure P2 and temperature T2 at the end of the Fanon flow. Now the properties of air at inlet to the convergent divergent nozzle are at the outlet of the Fanon flow. So exit of the Fanon flow is inlet to the convergent divergent nozzle. P2 equal to P1 into P2 by P star divided by P1 by P star equal to 80 into 0.728 divided by 0.408 equal to 142.7 kilopascal. T2 equal to T1 into T2 by T star divided by T1 by T star equal to 293 into 0.897 divided by 0.667 equal to 394 Kelvin. Now from the isentropic table 3.2, page number 32. Now Mach number M2. So at the outlet of the Fanon flow, the Mach number is 1.3, gamma equal to 1.4. We take the property T2 by TO star TO2 equal to 0.747, T2 by PO2 equal to 0.361. Now the stagnation properties at the section 2. So TO2 equal to 394 divided by 0.747. So because T2 equal to 394 divided by the ratio 0.747. So stagnation temperature at the outlet at the section 2 equal to 527.4 Kelvin. Similarly, stagnation pressure at section 2, 142 divided by 0.361 equal to 142.7 divided by 0.361 equal to 395.3 kilopascal. Now for isentropic flow, TO2 equal to TO3 equal to TO4. So the stagnation temperature is constant for isentropic flow. Again, from the isentropic table, table number 3.2, page number 28, gamma equal to 1.4 and the area ratio, A4 by A3. A4 is the exit area, A3 is the throat area. So we, from the gas table, it is A4 by A star equal to 3. For this ratio, A by A star equal to 3, we take the condition. So here we have to be very careful. So here it is mentioned in the problem that they are the exit of the nozzle, the flow is subsonic. So we have to take the value from the subsonic condition, at the subsonic condition. For the same area ratio, supersonic condition properties also, supersonic condition also available, but we have to take carefully the subsonic property. M4 equal to 0.195. For the ratio, A4 by A star equal to 3, M4 equal to 0.195, P4 by PO4 equal to 0.974, T4 by TO4 equal to 0.9925. Now from the ratio of static to stagnation temperature and pressure, we calculate the properties. T4 equal to 0.9925 into TO4 equal to 0.9925 into 527.4 equal to 523.4 Kelvin. And the P4 equal to 0.974 into PO4 equal to 0.974 into 395.3 equal to 385 kilopascal. The answer to the problem, exit of the pipe, Mach number is 1.3, pressure is P2 equal to 142.7 kilopascal, temperature T2 equal to 394 Kelvin. Exit of the nozzle, M4 equal to 0.195, P4 equal to 385 kilopascal and T4 equal to 523.4 Kelvin. So these are all the answers to the problem. Example number 10, air flows through a convergent divergent nozzle and with a stagnation pressure 600 kilopascal and stagnation temperature 150 degrees Celsius. The Mach number being greater than 1 at the exit, at the nozzle exit. That is, at the exit of the nozzle, the flow is supersonic. The throat area of the nozzle is 1 cm square. The flow from the nozzle enters a duct which has a constant area of 3 cm square. The flow can be assumed to be isentropic in the nozzle, adiabatic in the duct, and if the mean friction factor is 0.004, find the pressure temperature on the exit plane of the duct when the flow is choked. And here, now initially it is isentropic flow in a convergent divergent nozzle, and then it is a constant area duct with a friction factor 0.004. We are given stagnation pressure PO1 at the entry, it is 600 kilopascal. TO1 stagnation temperature is 150 degrees Celsius. A2, area of the throat equal to 1 cm square. A3, area of the exit of the nozzle or area of dam, area of the constant area duct equal to 3 centimeter square, and the friction factor F equal to 0.004. Now from the isentropic table, table number 3.2, page number 36, for the area ratio A3 by A2 equal to A3 by A star equal to 3. So this is the reference value, A3 by A star equal to 3. This is what known value. For the known value, we have to take the property, Mach number P3 by PO3, PT3 by TO3. And the gamma equal to 1.4. So for air, gamma equal to 1.4, we have to take the property at the supersonic condition. Reason is here. So the Mach number being greater than 1 at the exit of nozzle exit. So at the outlet of the nozzle, the flow is supersonic. So M3 equal to 2.64 and gamma equal to 1.4. P3 by PO3 equal to 0.0471 and T3 by TO3 equal to 0.417. Now the properties of air at the entry to the duct or exit of the nozzle. P3 equal to 0.0471 into PO3, which is 0.0471 into 600 equal to 28.26 kilopascal. T3 equal to 0.417 into TO3, which is 0.417 into 423 equal to 176.39 Kelvin. From the fan of flow table, table number 6.2, page number 85, now Mach number M3 equal to 2.64 and gamma equal to 1.4. We take P3 by P star equal to 0.268, T3 by T star equal to 0.501. Now the properties of air at exit of the duct, P star equal to P4. So from the ratio, P star equal to P3 by 0.268, which is 28.26 divided by 0.268 equal to 105.4 kilopascal. Similarly, T star equal to T4, which is T3 by 0.501, which is 176.39 divided by 0.501 equal to 352 Kelvin. So the answer to the problem, the pressure at the exit of the duct 105.4 kilopascal and temperature at the exit of the duct 352 Kelvin. We stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering, and there is one book, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. You can refer to the book for additional problems in the fan of flow. I upload the video lectures of all the subject in the YouTube channel. You refer to the channel for your better learning in the mechanical engineering subjects. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in another video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. Until then, bye-bye.